محمد عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters, if you notice in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommends in many situations to be together as one jama'ah, as one group. For example, this salah, salatul jum'ah, we pray salat jum'ah in jama'ah together. We don't pray salat jum'ah alone. This is not allowed. And also every day we pray the five prayers in jama'ah. Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. Also Eid prayer, Kusuf prayer, and Kusuf for the sun and moon eclipse. When we eat, also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommended the Sahaba to eat together. Also, when the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum in a traveling, they want to take a rest. Each one went alone. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told them to stay together. Also, the jama'ah itself should be together. In the salah, the Muslim should be on one line, straight line. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La takhtalif wa takhtalif qulubukum." In the salah, don't differ in the salah. One of the men, little bit front, and one little bit back. He said, don't do this. Be in a straight line. Because if you differ in the line of the salah, it means your hearts will be different. Subhanallah. And Allah the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that yadullahi ala jama'ah. Allah is with the jama'ah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this concept in Islam is very important. And to be different, this is very bad. And this is the one of the aims of shaitan, to make the Muslims sects and different groups. So let's see some of the ayat and the hadith about this issue. Allah says in the Quran, وَاَعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and hold firmly to the rope of Allah all together. And don't become divided. وَاذْكُرُوا إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ. This ayah in Surah Ali Imran. And remember the favor of Allah upon you when you were enemies. And He brought your hearts together. And you became by His favor brothers. Like the society of Medina. How many groups in Medina? Maybe five groups. Aus, Khazraj, and the Yahud, Banu Qaynuqa, Banu Nadir, Banu Qurayza. Always they had fighting among them. But when they became Muslims, there was no Muhajir, no Aus and Khazraj. They became the Ansar. How they united? Because of Islam. La ilaha illallah united them. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another surah, وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. And obey Allah and His Messenger. And don't dispute and thus lose courage, and then your strength would depart. And be patient. Indeed, Allah is with the patient. So one of the reasons of weakness and fighting. So if we don't unite, it means weakness. ولا تنازعوا فتفشلوا. You fail. If you fight, if you dispute, if you hate each other. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and moreover, this is my path. صِرَاطُ مُسْتَقِيم, the straight path, is my path, which is straight. So follow it. And don't follow other ways, for you will be separated from his way. This is very important. Why we fight, disputing? Because we are not following, or many Muslims don't follow the straight path. But if they follow the straight path, they will unite. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us this is the way of the people before us, people of the book. They were different. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا وَاخْتَلَفُوا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want to be like them. And don't be like the ones who became divided and differed after the clear proofs had come to them. And alhamdulillah, we have the clear proofs, the Quran and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So why we differ? Because we live the Quran and Sunnah, or many of the Quran and Sunnah. In the hadith, Abu Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala an said about the believers, the relationship of the believer with another believer is like the bricks of the building. Al-mu'min lil-mu'min kal-bunyan yashuddu ba'duhu ba'dan. Each strengthens the other. How they made this masjid and the houses. Like these bricks. One brick will not make the masjid. And also all the bricks alone will not make the masjid. But if you put them together, we found this masjid. The same thing, the Muslim Ummah. The Muslims, the Muslim alone will not make a nation. But if the Muslims unite, they will make an Ummah, a nation. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran and also Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Sunnah. Many ayat or some ayat and ahadith. How to unite, or the importance of making the Ummah, the Muslims, one nation. If there is any problem, we have to solve the problems among the Muslims. If it is between the brother and his brother, or his sister, or the husband, wife, or even between two groups, or two countries, we have to do the sulh to solve the problems. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in surah, the beginning of Surah Al-Anfal, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَنْفَالِ قُلِ الْأَنْفَالُ لِلَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَأَصْلِحُوا ذَاتَ بَيْنِكُمْ. They ask you, yeah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the ghanima, the bounties of the world. Say the decision concerning bounties is for Allah and the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So fear Allah and amend that which is between you and obey Allah and His Messenger. Because some of the Sahaba said, because we attacked the kuffar, so we should take the money. And some of them said, no, we should take the money because we were protecting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A third group said, no, we should take the money and the wealth because we were collecting the money from the kuffar. Subhanallah. So the differences came. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, no, this is for Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They have the right to divide the bounties. وَأَصْلِحُ ذَاتَ بَيْنِكُمْ. Don't differ. Subhanallah. Also another hadith, Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala said, by him in whose hand my soul is, you will not enter paradise until you believe. Only the believers, the Muslims, will enter Jannah. Until you believe.
And you will not believe until you love one another. It means the Muslims. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us what is the way to love each other. أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُ تَحَابَبْتُمْ. Should I not guide you to something doing which you will love one another? Spread out salutation among you. Give salam when you meet any Muslim, any Muslim. Give him salam. Say salamu alaikum. It is very easy. Very easy to give the salam, and you will get the ajr, and also you get the love from your brothers. Brothers and sisters, استغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وأصحابه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ألا أخبركم بأفضل من درجة الصلاة والصيام والصدقة. قالوا بلى. قال إصلاح ذات البين وفساد ذات البين الحالقة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, shall I not inform you of something more excellent in degree than fasting, praying and giving sadaqa, giving charity? The Sahaba said, yes, we want to know this. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, it is putting things right between people. When you solve the problems, maybe sometimes you need to spend money. Even the scholar said, you can give zakah to the people who are spending money in solving problems between the groups of Muslims. Why? Because of the importance of unity. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, وَفَسَادُ ذَاتِ الْبَيْنِ الْحَالِقَةِ. Spoiling them is the shaver, destructive. If you feel ill toward your brother and sister, it means al-haliqa. What is meaning al-haliqa? Like shaving your hair, the head. It means it will cut the relationship between you and the other Muslim. Subhanallah. Look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in the Quran. When he talked about the relationship between the husband and wife. وَإِنْ إِمْرَأَةٌ خَافَتْ مِنْ بَعْلِهَا نُشُوزًا أَوْ إِعْرَاضًا فَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْهِمَا يُصْلِحَا صُلْحًا وَالصُّلْحُ خَيْرٌ. The Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and settlement is best. Subhanallah, the problem is all the problem. And both of them suffering, but because of the shaitan blowing in each of them, the husband and wife. And none of them wants to compromise. But Allah said, وَالصُّلْحُ خَيْرٌ. Means if you compromise from your right, she or he, this is better for both of you. وَالصُّلْحُ خَيْرٌ. Why? Because in another surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. The believers are but brothers. فَاصْلِحُ بَيْنَ أَخْوِيكُمْ. So make settlement between your brothers. We are brothers. Any Muslim in any country, any language, any color, we are brothers. Allah sent Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to teach us this concept. All the Muslims are brothers. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in Surah Al-Hujurat, if there is fighting between two countries or two groups of Muslims, وَإِن طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ اقْتَتَلُوا فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا. And if two factions among the believers should fight, then make settlement between the two. You have to do this. So why these ayat and ahadith? Why these verses and ahadith? Because of the importance of unity. Because if we lose the unity, then we'll be very weak. Sa'd ibn Sa'd narrated a hadith that the people of Quba اقتتلوا حتى تراموا بالحجارة. He said, رضي الله تعالى, people of Quba fought with each other
till they throw stones on each other. They are human beings, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum. So subhanAllah, this happened. When the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was informed, what he said, let us go to bring about a reconciliation between them. Immediately the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to them. He did not say, I will delay. Let them solve their problem. No. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows the importance of unity. So brothers and sisters, the most important point in this topic is taqwallah, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then if you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you work for this. And also we have to make a sincere dua for the Muslim Ummah to unite. Allahumma khfir lil mu'mineen al mu'minat wal muslimin al muslimat la ihya'un wal mat innaka sami'un qareebun ujibu al da'wah.